question is, how can we elicit the strategy? Now we know that it's so beneficial, but how do you get this? The key is how. You see, NLP teaches two types of way to get the strategy. One way is called formal elicitation. Another one is called informal elicitation. The thing is, when you're working with a client, let's say basically you're working with, let's say I want to work with Simon. I say, Simon, I want to work with you to help you to find your motivation strategy. Then I use what? Formal elicitation. Because Simon will be a what? Willing party. He's willing to let me go through the whole exercise to find out what his strategy is. But let's say, you know what, Simon is my boss. Do I go up to my boss and say, boss, I want to find out the motivation strategy. Can I elicit it from you? It can't happen, right? So you have to use an informal elicitation. So how do you do informal one? Okay, formal one, very simple. You look at page 76. Okay, before we go any further, I want to share this that, you know what, when we're talking about strategies, whether you're talking about motivation strategies, whether you're talking about love, whether you're talking about buying strategies, the elicitation process is what? The same. It is similar. You follow the script found in page 76. Okay, it's similar. The thing is, you just need to know what is it that you are eliciting. Let's say it's a buying strategy, instead of saying what? Can you recall a time when you're totally motivated? You ask what? What do you ask? Can you remember a time when you last bought something? In fact, buying strategy itself is quite unique because in a way, buying strategy is a very complex behavior. It comprises of three components, three phases. The first phase is what? Motivation to buy. You see, buying is not as simple as buying something unless you're talking about a what? A stimulus kind of buying. Stimulus buying is, I see it, I buy. That one is stimulus buying. Like maybe I see a pen, I see a ballpoint pen, 30 cent. I think about it, hey, I need a ballpoint pen, I buy it. Don't tell me a ballpoint pen, 30 cent, I still think how to buy, should I really buy or not? I think you think about 30 cent, I don't buy. This stimulus buying, okay? But the kind of strategies I'm referring to here is complex. So, how do even the complex buying behavior, usually there are three phases. The first phase is, how do I motivate client to buy first? Because if he's not motivated, he will never buy the product. But motivation is the first part. Second part is what? Second part is the decision part. You see, when client is motivated to buy a car, the next thing that has to happen is what? Client has to know what? Has to decide which is the car to buy. But after he bought the car, it hasn't ended yet. What's going to happen? There's a reassurance. You see, buying strategy has three components. First one is motivation. Second one is decision. Third one is whether or not he's going to be happy. If he's not happy, he will not come back and buy again. If he's not happy, that means this is a lousy strategy. That means if you use the same strategy again for Clive, he may not be happy with the decision. So obviously, if I am a salesperson, now, if I'm a salesperson, do I want to find out my client's positive strategy or negative one? Of course, the positive one, right? Because when I find out what Aaron's positive strategy is, then when I use it, when I utilize it, it will have an impact on him and he will feel positive about it. But if I use his negative strategy, eventually he may hate me for it. Even if he were to buy my product now, he will hate me 5 years later. He say, you know, why did you ask me to buy this thing? I'm not happy about decision. Okay, so